will call this meeting, the December 4th City Council meeting from Kirksville to order. Invocation by Taylor Carr.
Good evening, if you could join
together with me in prayer. Father God, we thank you for being able to gather here today. We thank you for your many blessings. We thank you for the freedom and safety and the sacrifices of so many that preserve it and protect it. Thank you that we have a voice, a city council that listens, and the opportunity to help Kirksville become an even better place to live. Most of all, Lord, we thank you for the opportunity you give us to seek you and inquire of you. And tonight we pray for your favor and presence tonight as the city council of Kirksville meets the village of churches. And we pray to be in tune with the welfare and needs of the people. We pray for unity, even if there's disagreement. We pray for true and appropriate justice, for empathy, compassion, perseverance. We pray that any difficult decision be made today that it be guided with truly godly wisdom. As Prophet Jeremiah stated, "Seek the peace and prosperity of the city to which I carried you into exile. Pray to the Lord for it, because if it prospers, you too will prosper." So Lord, tonight we pray tonight for the city of Kirksville to prosper. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Has everybody got a chance to look at the meetings from November 20th? So a motion is accepted to approve the minutes as distributed. So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Order the agenda.
There are no changes.
Okay. Motion is second to approve the order of the agenda.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Information presentation and public hearing. Nothing on that, so move on. Citizen participation. Does anybody have anything on the that they want to talk about that is not on the agenda this evening? We have 5 minutes to speak about that. Okay. Seeing none. Unfinished business. Looks like there's none. Action presentations. City Clerk reading of Bill Number 59.
An ordinance to amend the 2017 budget for the City of Kirksville to account for year-end adjustments.
Motion second.
So moved.
Second.
Good evening, Mayor and Council. I come to you tonight for two reasons. One would be to amend our 2017 budget as we're wrapping up the year-end, and then later in the agenda, I will be presenting the first reading for the 2018 budget. When we started the budget process in August, part of our process is to see and forecast where we're going to be at the end of 2017. When we adopted the budget at the beginning of 2017, we had a plan of action, but as capital projects came up or we received new grants or had opportunities to do capital infrastructure with cost share, that budget has changed. And then as departments have been able to find savings in capital, have been able to find savings in operations, those will also decrease our budget. So what I am asking you to do tonight is to revise the 2017 budget. What we have found is a decrease of the original budget that we have of $5.8 million. So our budget will go from $42,194,318 to $36,340,065. And that is seen over all of our accounts. There's not one specific account. You have a summary in your packet that will show the decreases in all of our different funds. Now, also attributing to this decrease would be capital projects that we have found were not going to get completed at the end of 2017, and we have pushed those into 2018, and we'll have some changes, slight changes, from when we had our meeting in November. We'll discuss those. Probably the largest decrease that you'll see will be in the utility fund, and a huge portion of that has to do with capital savings. We saved a little over $1 million in capital savings. Mostly it's attributable to our wastewater treatment plant. As part of DNR's requirements when we had the wastewater treatment plant, they made us have at least 5% of the project in contingency, and so we accounted for that. Well, it looks like our project is not going to use all of that contingency, so this budget is adjusted, and that is a big part of that decrease. And then the capital improvement sales tax fund, there's a little over $1.2 million decrease in it, and that is mostly because we have not had a determination made on our shooting park. And that is a $1 million project. So those are the significant decreases to the budget. Do you have any questions for me regarding these?
Any council discussion? Okay. Citizens' questions or input? Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay. City Clerk's second reading.
An ordinance to amend the 2017 budget for the City of Kirksville to account for year-end adjustments.
So a motion and second to approve on second reading.
So moved.
Second.
Any discussion? Any citizen input? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay. City Clerk reading of Bill Number 60.
An ordinance to adopt the 2018 fiscal year budget for the City of Kirksville on first reading only.
Motion and second.
So moved.
Second.
Part two of my presentation tonight is to ask Council to adopt on the first reading our 2018 budget. We started this process in August. It has been a labor of love, as all budgets always are. This year, our 2018 proposed budget includes aggregate expenditures of $38,356,030. Like I mentioned earlier, this is slightly different than what we discussed at our November meeting, but we took Council's input and we have put those in these changes. And then also some of the projects that we discussed, for instance, the brick banding, those are moved to 2018 from 2017's budget. As it stands, this is an increase of 5.5% from our amended 2017 budget. Of those budgets, the utility fund is 35% of that budget amount. Emergency services, which includes 911, police, and fire, they're 18% of that budget. Public works, streets, codes, and engineering is 17% of that. Our internal service funds, which includes central garage and our health insurance, that's 8% of the budget. Transportation is 4%, which is part of the airport fund. And then our recreation services, this is a new item that I have added from prior years, that will be 5% of our budget. The remaining 13% of the budget will be for community support, administrative services, support to K-Ready, economic development support, downtown infrastructure, which is part of the TIF, and then the CIDs would be included in that. Of the $38 million budget, $12.7 million is included for capital infrastructure, and that's roughly 33% of our total 2018 budget. Do you have any questions for me regarding that?
Any council discussion?
So I do want to mention, Lacey talked about the brick banding project. So when you get a chance, please go by Bank Midwest and look at it. I think you'll be pleased with the results, and we will not have to pay for the bond. Just had to write a letter to the bonding company saying that the city council chose to not do the project.
Yeah, I went by there today and I think they look a lot better.
It looks really good.
A lot safer in the future.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, any other discussion? Mm-hmm. Any citizen questions or input? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay. City Clerk reading of Bill Number 61.
An ordinance to allow the city to join the Show Me Pace Clean Energy Development Board, which includes the approval of this organization's bylaws and the execution of a cooperative agreement.
Motion and second.
So moved.
Second. Mayor and Council, so good evening.
So I think we're all familiar with PACE, which is Property Assessed Clean Energy, which allows for property owners, either private or public, to pay for energy efficient improvements to their property through an assessment on their annual property tax bill. And this legislation was authorized in 2010 by the Missouri General Assembly, and that allowed for the creation of clean energy development boards. And there are two primary clean energy development boards in the state of Missouri which facilitate PACE financing or PACE programs. And the city is already a member of one, as was discussed in the study session, right? The Missouri Clean Energy District, and joined that district in 2013. And now what we're discussing this evening is the other primary clean energy development board that allows for PACE financing, which is the Show Me PACE Clean Energy Development Board. And so if you all were to vote to have the city of Kirksville join the Show Me PACE and Clean Energy Development Board, what does that do? It simply provides more options for those property owners looking to do PACE financing in the city of Kirksville. And also I'd note a few things. Over time, the current district that we're a part of, the Missouri Clean Energy District, or the Clean Energy Development Board, I should say, not district, they have come to focus primarily on residential PACE, which is PACE for obviously private residences, whereas Show Me PACE, which is this particular clean energy board that we're discussing this evening, has come to focus more on commercial projects, which are projects that we as a city are especially interested in, right, for the purposes of economic development. And the nice thing about commercial PACE, or C-PACE, as opposed to residential PACE, or R-PACE, is that Show Me PACE would actually employ a third party who would collect those property tax assessments. So there's no additional work for the Adair County Collector's Office in collecting the assessment that then pays for whatever energy efficient improvement has been made to that commercial property, be it, new windows or solar panels or geothermal heating or whatever the case might be. And so unless there are any questions, I'd be happy to talk more about it. It's a fairly straightforward proposal, and it simply gives folks in Kirksville more options when it comes to PACE financing, if they so choose.
Any council discussion?
Any citizen input or discussion? All in favor? Any opposed? So second reading.
Ordinance to allow the city to join the Show Me PACE Clean Energy Development Board, which includes the approval of this organization's bylaws and the execution of a cooperative agreement.
Motion second to approve on second reading.
So moved. Second.
Any discussion? Citizen questions or input? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? All right. Motion second to authorize the city manager to execute an agreement with Axon Enterprises, Inc. for the purchase of body-worn cameras, supportive software, cloud-based data storage, and a 5-year warranty.
So moved. Second.
Mr. Mayor, members of council, you know that we have been working on this for about 14 months. I know that we have filed a number of updates to try to keep you posted of our status. It's been a interesting learning experience. I could go on for a long time, but I'm not going to do that. Certainly, if you have questions, I'd be more than happy to answer them. I've described this a little bit when we started this. It's like going out to look for a Christmas puppy. They all come in all different shapes and sizes, and they all do different things. And that's what we've discovered. In fact, part of the recommendation, it talked about that the product that we're getting meet all the criteria. That's true. But it doesn't necessarily mean that they met all the original specs, because we've worked on this for about 12 months and there's been some changes in what we have learned. It's been a very instructional period over that period of time. The one I'm thinking about, I know that this company had a workaround for it. I just wanted to make sure that you all knew that. It certainly is not the cheapest, but it's not, I don't believe, the most expensive system out there. But in testing it, it by far and away exceeded any of the other systems. As an example, there was a system that I was pretty high on, and I think everybody on the committee knew that, and they kind of thought, oh, this is the the system the chief favors, and it's a slam dunk, but when we tested it, it actually came out at the, pretty much at the bottom. I mean, that's how expectations sometimes don't always, you know, you don't always meet all those expectations. And so the long and the short of it is, this is a very, it's Axon Industries, but it's associated with Taser, was associated with Taser at one point, which has a long history. They've been in the business for quite a while. They're not one of those companies that just popped up after what the events from Ferguson and some of the other events after that. So it's got a very long history to it. And one of the things that sold us on this, cameras are cameras, although all of them have different bells and whistles. But quite honestly, the software to manage all of these videos is going to be a horrendous part of this system. And this has, from what I could determine, has the at least the best software management piece out of all of that we tested based on the way that we would like to conduct business. And so that's kind of where we're at. That's how we got to Taser out of the 12, out of Axon, excuse me, out of the 12 systems. That's why we went with them again, even though they weren't the lowest bidder. Again, it's like those Christmas puppies. Sometimes you do get what you pay for. We're going with basically a 5-year warranty, which has some advantages too. We have a what they call the Taser Assurance Plan. And what that means is it basically, the cameras and the software basically have a bumper-to-bumper, my words, bumper-to-bumper warranty. And in fact, in 2.5 years, we will get new, the way that I understand the system, I don't want to misstate anything here. If I do, I apologize. But in 2.5 years, we actually, without even asking for them, will get new camera systems because they'll be exposed to the elements, they'll be dropped, they'll be bumped, and all those kinds of things. And so replacements, we get replacements anytime we want. And we'll get total replacement in 2.5 years, which means if they come out, this is their second generation product. So if we have a, if they come out with another generation between now and then, we'll get the brand new system as well. And as you noticed in your recommendation, as a coincidence, it's the same system, the same camera system that the Sheriff's Department has been using for how long, Bill?
That was right after Ferguson, so about 2 years.
About 2 years. Everything. It just ended up being a coincidence that they've been using that system as well. So. Don't know if there's any questions or anything that I can answer.
Before you ask the question, Rick, just want to mention, in the motion it does talk about the cloud-based storage. When we originally put the budget together, we were not going to do cloud-based.
Correct.
But that change has been made, and so that was a savings. We had money set aside that we were going to have to pay every year for that. I think it was $4,000 or something like that.
Right, and I think in talking to Sheriff Hardin the other day, I think maybe they're going to need to add some storage or something. Are you aware? I don't want to, we're just having a general conversation. I don't want to misstate anything, so I'm not sure.
So, Rick, I apologize. Rick,
that was my question about the data storage, so thank you.
I mean, and there's a lot of advantages to the cloud-based storage. The disadvantage is we don't really give up control. We actually get a lot by doing that, but it just takes some of the burden off of us. And if a big thing for me is if there's a screw-up, it's not like the police did something to hide. It's something that the company would have done, not us. And so to me, that was a huge piece to the cloud-based storage system. Plus which they have a number of redundant sites. So if a site in town X would happen to go down, that is already backed up here and that sort of thing. So it's been a long process. We learned a lot. If we were to do it again from today is day one, we'd get through it a lot faster and we'd know a little bit more what we're talking about, but we've learned a lot. So I appreciate your patience.
The other thing is we did make sure that if the council does approve this evening, that he can place the order and he can get those in before the end of the year.
Correct. And Mary, I'm not sure, did you see Sarah's? Sarah says that we had one question coming in tonight, a couple of questions. One was John and the other one was insurance. Sarah looked at him and the insurance absolutely does apply. However, the insurance piece expires in 11 days because of the end of the year, their period, and so we'll just get them to, so that's contingent on them renewing that insurance as well. So Sarah's left a note that the insurance did seem to apply.
Okay,
so,
thank you.
So anyway, I got a whole bunch of stuff here and a year and a half worth of stuff. If you have any questions, just let me know. So we're excited by this. So.
Any other council discussion? Any questions from the public? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Council comments. Anybody have anything they'd like to say or congratulate?
I know it's council comments, but I do want to thank our commissioner, Bill King, for he's at the council meeting this evening, but you were also at our events on Friday, and even though it wasn't recognized that day, you know, your presence was noted, and it is truly appreciated that you're there and support us. So thank you.
Thank you.
Anybody else?
I want to thank Rodney for coming tonight, our new Parks and Rec director. Thank you for introducing yourself to the council.
Okay. All right. Motion and second to adjourn to an executive session, legal matter, and personnel matter.
So moved. Second.
Okay, roll call vote.
Mayor Vista?
Aye.
Councilmember Steele?
Aye.
Councilmember Detweiler?
Aye.
Councilmember Mills is absent. Councilmember Long?